All right. So here is Tecno Camo 17, a smartphone that can do many things, but it is not made for everyone. There are some super fantastic things about this smartphone, and also there are some restrictions that is pulling this smartphone behind. It is the cheapest of all the Camo 17 series. The Pro version is the best in the series, and just in case you haven't seen it, I will link my first impression of it in the description below. So, comparing the Camo 17 to the Camo 17 Pro, the difference in price is almost times 2. That means if you are buying the Camo 17 over the Pro, you will actually be saving a lot of money. But is it worth it? Will the Camo 17 give you the same value as the Pro? Well, I'm going to tell you the good and the bad of this device. So which one should come first? Okay, the good. Alright. First, let's start with the camera. In a bid to cut down the cost of this smartphone and to make it more affordable and cheaper, Tecno used 48 megapixel sensor on the rear camera instead of the 64 megapixel on the Camo 17 Pro and Camo 17P. But does this reduction affect the performance of the camera? Well, during daytime, you might not notice because it can take clear and crisp images. However, it is kind of oily sometimes, like it's too overly saturated sometimes. So under low light conditions, so you always need to use flashlight for you to get a better result at night. The super night mode sucks. The selfie camera is just there in between good and bad. So it's just there. But aside from that, when it comes to performance, the Tecno Camo 17 is powered by the MediaTek Helio G85, which is good for long-time gaming. I played game with it, Car Racing. It was fantastic. I didn't experience any lagging, but the problem here is the RAM size. 4 GB of RAM is too small. So there is a limit to the heavy application you can install on this smartphone. That means the phone will get slower with the more heavy applications you install on it over time. Tecno could have just made it 6 GB of RAM, but it is what it is, 4 GB. And that brings us to the display and design. What I love about the display is the 90Hz refresh rate. But what I hate about the display is the fact that this screen is 720p screen resolution. What I love about the design is how strong the body build is. The Camo 17 is a very strong device, but what I hate about it is that this selfie camera, this thing right here, is too big on the screen. It turns me off completely. And the speaker is also average, not super fantastic like the one you get in Galaxy A32 and Redmi Note 10 Pro, but not terrible as well like what you get in Tecno Spark 7P. So it is just a mediocre in between. The battery life is good. It will last you for days with a single charge. And this being 2021, Tecno, we don't want to see a micro USB on any device. It's either USB Type-C or nothing. Lastly, the smartphone runs Android 11 out of the box, which is cool. But sadly, it will die Android 11. No major software update promise from Tecno, which is bad. The truth is that once Tecno can fix these software update issues, it will enhance their growth. So it's more like a win-win for the buyer and also for the tech company, because such step will open more doors for them in other markets, the Asia market, Europe, and even America, as already getting their foot strong on African soil already. So, but the point is that this smartphone is cool, but the restrictions are there, the challenges are there. I hope Tecno can do the needful and fix the software updates so we can get regular software on all their major smartphones. So having said all this about Tecno Camo 17, who should go for a Tecno Camo 17? Well, I'll say this. If you know you are a heavy user, that you play a lot of intensive games, and you also use your smartphone for heavy multitasking and use of big applications that are consuming, 4 GB of RAM will make your smartphone experience to be cramped. So the 4 GB of RAM is too small. So maybe you go for the 6 GB of RAM on the Tecno Camo 17P or Tecno Camo 17 Pro with 8 GB of RAM, because the 4 GB of RAM restrict the MediaTek Helio G85 we have here that was supposed to be an awesome experience. So for light users, Canon Camera 17 is one of the best mid-range smartphones for you to get. But for heavy users, maybe it's time you add back some money and go and get the Tecno Camera 17P or Tecno Camera 17 Pro, because it seems to suit you better. You have 8 gigs of RAM and 256 gigs of internal storage. Having said that, let me know what you think in the comment section about the review of the Tecno Camera 17. And if you find this video helpful, give the video a thumbs up and also turn on the post notification and click subscribe button. Also follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at MyG. I will link it below in the description. Just click it and follow me straight up. It's MyG. Thanks for watching, and I will see you around in my next one.